Welcome, everybody. My name is Joost Bonsen. I'd like to share with you just some few of our lessons in curating innovation in the sort of MIT venture landscape. First, what do we mean? Let's count the consequences of entrepreneurial action. If you look at all these logos, these are just a few of the thousands of MIT-related companies born over the 150-some-odd years that MIT faculty and students have been doing venture action. But when you look at these logos, see more than just the particulars about those companies. These are logos representing the birth of entire industries: biotechnology, semiconductors, consumer electronics, and much more. These logos also represent the talent, the people, the teams who connect with one another and do the work of starting, building, and growing companies. Now, I ran something called the Founders Project at MIT to try to quantify the economic impact of all of our alumni ever. And the bottom lines are big. Thousands of companies employ over a million people and have aggregate annual revenue of at least $250 billion. And those are just the numbers when we did this work first, the first global census in the 90s. Now, our colleagues at Sloan think those numbers are even bigger today. But what was especially interesting about this work is that we not only saw a doubling per decade of the number of ventures born of MIT-related people, but we also came to appreciate a lot about where these ventures happen, how ideas flow, and especially the role of creative places. Where does a new venture occur? Now, I happened to grow up in Silicon Valley, but ended up coming here to Cambridge for my undergrad studies. At MIT, electrical engineering, later in the business school, today in the media lab, part of our School of Architecture and Planning. We're surrounded as a campus by a technology venture zone. This is a place where tremendous creativity happens in an incredibly concentrated area. 50 years ago, though, this was dilapidated, rundown former industrial zone. Everything has changed in the interim, and this was very much by intention. MIT is a university with our leadership invested in first Technology Square, later Cambridge Center, University Park, and more. One of our alums runs a startup hotel, the Cambridge Innovation Center. Over 500 startups and emerging growth companies in Kendall Square, in just one building that MIT today owns. Understanding this is the stuff of our City Science Initiative. The Innovation Hub's workshop is exploring how to learn lessons from what works and doesn't, and try to replicate and make better these creative places. But it's not just the geography of innovation, it's also how ideas flow between key people. Now, one crude way of looking at the MIT venture landscape is through this metaphor of the innovation pipeline. Of course, it's more complicated than a simple linear flow, but the idea of going from creative ideation to having ever more real-world impact is one central to academia. Now, within this landscape, we have a huge infrastructure and support network, organizations from the informal and extracurricular to the formal that support venture activity. Now, I've personally been involved in run, founded, or built at least half of these, but I want to spotlight just a few in the short time we have today: our entrepreneurship competition, our licensing office, and some of the things that we do here at the MIT Media Lab. Now, this is the end goal of an entrepreneurship contest. It's getting the check on stage from a famous venture capitalist. This is grant money to help get you going. But this is the end of an academic exercise. There's still a lot to be done in actually founding and building and growing the company. These are our former students from the business school who ended up connecting through our venture ecology with an incredibly important pool of co-founders, the people who helped them grow and build this business, Synergy, which solves the waste-to-energy problem in the slums of East Africa, starting in Nairobi, Kenya. This story, this Synergy story, has been repeated 100-fold by all these companies. These are just a few of the ventures born of this extracurricular activity run by the students for the students. It has led to publicly traded businesses, mostly firms sold and bought by others, but collectively, this is billions of dollars of market capitalization done through this extracurricular activity here at MIT. Now, the licensing office is the opposite end of the spectrum. They handle the formal stuff. So they're responsible every year for invention records, patenting, and ultimately licensing to both big and small companies. Here's the key figure. This shows a decade worth of licenses to spin-off companies. It's between 20 and 30 a year. We're talking about a formally licensed MIT-related company every 2 weeks on average. Now, we're here in the MIT Media Lab, a place that for 25 years has helped people see the future first. And the bulk of what happens here is thinking about thousands of potential new ideas every year and winnowing those down to the several dozen per season killer demos that illustrate a high concept. What's increasingly emerged, though, through our classes and through living lab activities is the testing of those ideas at scale in technology test beds, in market microcosms, to see what happens when these ideas are engaged with real people. That's all pre-commercial academic work, but it helps and, in fact, kickstarts the process of going beyond the boundaries of academia, cross the red line, do something that has commercial consequence and real-world impact. Now, this too has happened hundredfold here at the lab in our time. Big companies and small, namely corporate ventures, as well as for-profit and non-profit activities, all born from this process. Just a few tasty examples. From an idea originally in a class, leading to a research agenda, ultimately funded by our sponsoring companies, came the venture e-ink, pioneering electronic ink technology in e-book readers. From an extracurricular idea to make programmable Legos came a research project that begat a sponsor venture, Legos, Mindstorm product line. From doctoral research, looking at an MIT undergraduate dormitory, seeing the connections between students, both of ideas and of ailments, begat an mHealth venture, Ginger.io. These are just a few examples of this commercialization process. Now, we're not only about learning by doing, the mens et manis in MIT's logo, or motto, I should say, but also about learning from one another and learning from our predecessors. Look at that same MIT scale pipeline. All these classes are action labs at the Institute, where people learn by doing something real at each of these phases of creative action. The Media Lab ones are square in this family, but we do this work around super themes, helping students consider how to take an idea from lab and bring it to real life. Now, there's been, over the course of our decade of doing this work, over 100 companies born from these venture classes. We learn lessons not only from students working with one another across disciplinary boundaries, but from looking at these past companies as live case studies. Alums who sat in the seats that the students are currently sitting in come back and share their saga, what worked and didn't, what's going well, what they wish they knew back when they were in school. This process is fantastically important for actually enabling this larger theme of curating innovation, helping make connections between us, the real world, through entrepreneurial action. Thank you.